Talk and Power, your motorsport and motoring radio show. Now on 88.5 FM, the Valley comes alive. And podcasting across iTunes and talkandpower.com.au.
I'm joined by Trini and Jason Mann. Thanks for coming on the podcast. It's great to have you here. I must be honest with you. I did preface our discussion by saying I don't know a lot about go-karting, so I guess that's why you've come on to the podcast, to tell us a little bit about the work you do. We've been a brand ambassador for Penrite and been in the go-kart scene. So tell us a little bit about yourself, Trina. You started racing when you were 12, is that correct?
Yeah. So I started racing when I was 12, pretty much gone through all the classes. So cadets, juniors, seniors, pretty much at my highest peak right now for my senior category.
Yep.
Next step for seniors would be KZs, but still a while away that one. Yeah.
Yep.
So KZs are the 125, but they got the 6-speed gearbox on them.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Jason, you were explaining before, because I don't want to sound like I know what I'm talking about, but you explained the acronym TAG. So just explain to our listeners, currently Trina's in a TAG. So tell us a bit about the TAG
car. Yeah, so we're in TAG 125 Lite is the class we race here in WA. Mm-hmm. And if we were to go nationally, it would be X30. So yep. Basically TAG 125, so TAG stands for a touch and go.
Yep.
You basically buy your engine, put it on the kart and go racing, not allowed to modify it hugely in any way. You can do little bits and pieces, but relatively straight out the box on the chassis and go racing.
So yeah, okay. Yep.
It's a very controlled, competitive environment where, you know, really the driver makes the kart work and, you know,
Yep. Tell us a bit about that then, Trina. You mentioned in the notes here as well. So one of the biggest challenges is being a girl in a sport that's dominated, as we know, by boys and by males. Tell us what it's like coming through the ranks as a female in go-karting.
It's definitely challenging because you get all your looks and you can't do this, or you'll have your challenges where you'll get blocked, and just your every daily racing competitiveness.
Yep.
Between everyone. Being a girl coming through as the motorsport is definitely different, especially because there's not a lot of girls out there that race. So to be in a high rank in the category that I'm in anyway is definitely a big step, and boys don't technically like it.
Yep. But do you think then, I'm going to ask you a question without notice here, but do you think it's because really motorsport, and we've been saying this on the podcast for a long time, motorsport is really the only sport on the planet where males and females can compete against each other, and it doesn't matter what gender you are. Like, you look at football, I think there's a gender, that you just cannot be it can't be the same. But motorsport takes all of that out of it, because at the end of the day, it's based on, I guess, talent.
Yeah, 100%. At the end of the day, it comes down to fitness and your racecraft. It's not as though it's just sit in a seat and you got to press your pedals and think about where your braking points and accelerating points. You've really got to study your track and narrow it down to who can brake the latest and who can hold the accelerator on the longest, pretty much.
Yeah. So do you think in karting in particular, there needs to be perhaps like further, like obviously more girls doing it and more education for everyone?
Yeah, 100%. I reckon there should be heaps more girls that race in any motorsport, whether it's karting, sprint cars, supercars, drift cars, whatever it is. I really think karting is underestimated for what it actually is, and I think it should be displayed more so more girls can get the idea and see how fun it is, and it's not just all nitty gritty. You meet nice friends, becomes one big family, really.
Yeah, okay.
So
yep.
It's not just the racing that counts for me as well.
I have to be honest with you. I think Foxtel and people, they're doing a lot of Cardi now as well. I've noticed. It's international, obviously, but I think that's bringing the sport up as well. I watch a bit of that. And really, Cardi is, when you think about it, like I know these, even the cars I'm pointing to, I think that's Matt Payne's car there, or whatever it is, David Reynolds or Matt Payne's car here.
Yeah.
That's supposed to be a controlled category, but I think really when you think about it, karting is the ultimate controlled category, isn't it?
Yeah, very controlled category, 100%, in many, many, many ways.
Yeah.
Also, with karting, you know, you've got to eliminate, we don't have suspension. They're a rigid chassis.
Mm-hmm.
So really on race day, it's how the mechanic works with the driver, gets the feedback, and then adopts that for the track surface of the day, you know.
Yeah.
You go out in the morning and then, you know, come late afternoon when you're going out for more heat races, you're generally walking around trying to get as much info as you can to do those few tweaks to make that kart work in the heat of the day, you know.
Yeah.
So
yep.
It's not only the driver, but, you know, it's the mechanic getting the kart right, the setup right to, you know, make it work all on the day.
Yeah. I noticed karting in particular, you get I don't know if this is what you call it, but when I've karted in the past, it gets bogged down in a corner, or you know, you're sliding into a corner and you're losing too much speed. Those sort of things are really crucial in cutting quick laps, aren't they?
Yeah, there's like, can be up to a second, 2 seconds into things like that. So that's where you got to really bond with your mechanic and your team or whoever is your pit crew for that weekend and tell them what it's doing and give them best advice and feedback that you possibly can so they can help fix that.
Yeah.
It's just like all forms of motorsport. Anyone can go fast in a straight line. It's making the kart, you know, making the vehicle turn and maintaining that momentum to keep in front.
Yeah. Any particular goals for yourself in the near future?
Probably just to keep going where I'm going and compete in more national rounds.
Mm-hmm.
And see how high national rounds can get me, like where I can place.
Yeah.
And then if I can do well in tag or X30 in national rounds, maybe in the near future look at doing KZs.
Yeah, okay.
But for now, pretty content with my little tag over there.
Yeah, okay. Looks like it's an amazing little cart. I shouldn't call it little. It's an amazing bit of equipment. So if people want to see it, where can they find any? Do you have a Facebook page or a website that they can go to?
Yeah, we have heaps of main contact points. We have my page, which is displayed as well, which is Chinaman Racing.
Mm-hmm.
There's the clubs, which is Tiger Kart Club, Wanneroo.
I meant to ask you that. So you're members of Tiger? Yep.
Tiger Kart Club.
Great kart club, aren't they? Yep.
Very great facility.
Yep. Okay. Who you like? Tell us. Is anyone you want to thank getting you here so far?
Yeah, my dad, my mum. Mainly, wouldn't be here where I am now without them, and their financial well-being as well. And Penrite, this being my third year with them as well, been keeping them on as an ambassador for them has been a great experience as well.
Yep. It is a great Australian company, and you know, one of the, you know, great Aussie success stories with them when you think about it. So that's it's great you could be here, Trenna. It's really great to have you on the podcast. Well, look, thanks for coming on. Really appreciate it. And I ask our listeners to go look you up on Facebook and get to an event when they can. I know that racing happens nearly all year round. There's not much off time for karting, isn't it?
No.
Yeah. I guess for the next major race for karting, we just had the national round here at Wanneroo last weekend.
Yep.
And, you know, like, the supercars now, the karting family, they're all off to Newcastle where the next major round is.
So. Okay, all right. Well, best of luck, and thanks for coming on the podcast. Really appreciate your time.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you.